Hey YouTube, it's still day five of the birthday stream, which is every $31 donated extends the timer by an hour. We've already streamed for I think close to 28, 29 hours, and there's 48 left. So, you know, it's going. Anyway. We're going to play Slime Rancher. I've played this game before on the channel. I did an entire playthrough of the Deluxe Edition on PS4 back in 2020. And then also in 2020, I did an entire playthrough all in one stream just to see if I could platinum it in one stream. I think it took like 12 hours. This is a little more casual. Playing it on the Xbox just to get some achievements again. Just wanted an excuse to play it. It's a really good game. It's one of my favorites in the last like decade or so. I don't know, it's got a really good feedback loop, so let's get to it. Gotta do the tutorial stuff real quick. I wonder if I can just start. Can I just start going? Hooray! Jump! Sprint! For those who have not played Slime Rancher, it's I would call it as a rancher game. I know that's annoying. But I mean, it's like kind of like farming, kind of like, kind of not, kind of like business management and stuff like that. It's a good time. The basic idea is that you want to gather as many slimes as possible, and or many of the different slimes possible. Kind of crossbreed them, figure out what their favorite foods are and stuff like that, and just they'll make little slime plorts. And then once you once all the slimes have made their plorts, they'll be good to go, and you can start selling them. So it's like part money management, businessy type, part rancher and stuff like that. Just a good time. I just really enjoy it. It's one of those things that I just like. I'll start up a playthrough and just go nuts. So yeah, as you can see, these guys will they'll munch anything. Pink slimes are the most generic ones. They'll eat anything, but because of that, they don't really have a favorite food. And they're not worth very much. These plorts, these little gems. So they're good in the beginning, just to kind of get your feet off the ground, I guess. But you don't need to go too hard into them. You can also suck up the slimes. I keep doing it by accident. yeah, let's keep moving. I know the area fairly well. Oh, we can go do that guy right real quick. Yeah, let's do that right off the bat. I don't have a jetpack yet. Fuck. Okay. So sometimes you'll find big old boys. Big old boys require more food than the rest, but once you feed all the food, they'll disappear and explode into goodies. I think this one takes 20 or 30. It's 30. Okay. Woo! Got ourselves a slime key. Use those to unlock other areas of the game. Ooh, a rock slime was hiding in there. Oh, achievement. Jelly Belly Burst. Burst a Gordo slime. Ooh, we got ornaments. Oh yeah, we'll probably find extra goodies because we are near Christmas time. It is Christmas Eve today. So there'll probably be some Christmas events going on. I know the Monomi Park is pretty good about that. Alright, so that was part of the DLC. We got a secret style, which makes all the pink slimes look a little glittery. And yeah, we're going to keep moving. I know this is a lot happening really fast, but I just, you know, I know the game pretty well, so I'm just sprinting on through. Chat, how are you guys doing? How are we doing today? You guys still feeling amped? Are you guys also feeling that I've been streaming for 5 days in a row? Is this starting to wear on you too? Or is that just me? Alright, so these guys are a little bit more rare. They're not, I wouldn't say they're rare, but they're a little more uncommon. So I'm gonna try and grab a few of them and we'll bring them back to the farm with us. What the fuck? They ate my carrot. Stop it. Fuck. Alright. I guess. So with these ornaments, you can just kind of, shoot them, and they'll just kind of hang in the air. So we'll just, you know, I'll just put them out as I go. We got tabby slimes! Ow. All right, so we're starting to see some of the mixtures here. Hi, Dr. Nick. Oh, thank you. Yes, I'm wearing my doctor's coat, of course. Because this is official. I'm a professional streamer, doing professional things. Right, I need another one of you. I don't think I need this tabby slime right now. I might keep it just in case, but... Downloaded vampires and I'm currently surviving them? Hell yeah. You're definitely more tired of me than I of you. I'm not tired of anyone. I'm tired of being on for a little bit. Like, of just being, like, active and like, hey, it's me, your favorite streamer! I'm getting a little tired of that, but beyond that, it's fine. That's why, you may have noticed, we're pivoting the games that I know I really, really like. It's to help me, like, boost up a little bit. That's my solution to kind of worrying about burnout is, well, I just simply won't burn out. I'll make it that easy. All right, got more of you guys. More of these. All right, so we get a little audio log here. I had a great big tree like this here, one along the edge of my property back on Earth. If I had been there before anyone else, it had been there before anyone could remember. So I have all kinds of change around it. And then one day I began to notice it was dying. Wasn't anything unnatural. It was just its time, I suppose. Then I realized that if I didn't do something, I'd end up like that tree. It's been my whole life in the same place. I wasn't going to let that happen. So I bought a ticket for the far, far range the very next day. That's where we are. We're currently in the far, far range. All right. Ooh, a tabby plort. Actually, I'm gonna get rid of all of these carrots. maybe not. So these are stony hens. They're somewhat rare, but not really. They just have a couple different like specific spawns. So the way this works is that each slime that you get can be combined with at least with up to one other slime. And once you do that, they'll return both of the. Both of their like kind of little plorts, their little drops at the same time. So you kind of want to mix and match them. It's also easier just to take care of like when they're like two and one. It's just a little easier to handle them that way. But the main thing is that they all have different diets too. So in this game there are fruits, vegetables, and chickens. Some slimes really like and only eat chickens and like you know, they're carnivores. Some can eat both. Some like fruit, some like vegetables. So what you want to do, and in my personal opinion, what you want to do is mix some of the what do you call it? My brain is just like melting. You want to mix the ones that are carnivores with the ones that are either vegetarians or whatever the thing for eating only fruit is. Because then it's just easier to feed them. Because chickens take a little bit of time to reproduce, but fruit and veg will grow pretty quickly. All right, so here is the... I'm just going to do this just to get the tutorial off my screen. Nope, that didn't work either. So this is the stock market. It shows you the different plorts and what they're all worth. Pink slimes are worth 13 right now, so there we go, get our money. So we got 393. Now I want to set up a little pen here for him. Usually I try to do 10 slime per pen, not too many. We'll do some high walls, and then we want to try and upgrade all this stuff, but it costs money, so back out I go. I think I'm gonna mix things up this time. I usually combine them together, but I'm not gonna do it this time. Like, I usually combine tabbies and rock slimes because they're like the first ones you find together, but you know, I'm not gonna do that this time. I'm gonna mix it up, but then I have to build another pen. Everything costs money. Everything in this game costs so much money. Yeah, I don't have enough for that. Okay. Alright, so I'm going back out in the wild. Actually, you know what? Just have fun, guys. Whatever happens, happens. I believe in you guys. All right. Don't you front seat us? I got some veggies too. I guess I can shoot those in there. Inspire growth. So basically the way it works is that if a slime eats another slime's plorts, they'll kind of mix together like this one in the middle where it's half cat, half rock. So So when we come back here, our farm is going to be a fucking mess. But for now, just trying to get things out. Like, as you can see, if there's too many and there's no, like, air net, they'll just start, like, popping out. And you don't really want that to happen, so. I'm gonna try and separate them a little bit. Grab all the tabbies out of here. Okay. Ow. Alright, that seems good enough for now. Alright, hey. Get back in there. What are you doing? This is why you need those high walls, because they like to bounce out and cause all sorts of mischief. The auto plort collector would have been really cool here, too. I'm trying to go around here. Hey, guys. Carrots. Enjoy. Eat your carrots, boys! Okay. So, because it's a stock market-based system, there is a part of... There's kind of like a... Not unspoken, I guess, but like there's an aspect of like... You want to make sure that you kind of sell them all at once, and you don't really like sell it over a couple days because the price will drop, because there'll be plenty in demand. So I'm doing my best here to avoid that, and it's going okay. Let's see, shoot one at this one. There you go. Any more normal slimes in here? No, you guys are all mixed. Cool. Like our sandwich last night was for which part? Plort market. All right, getting some more money back. I don't want these tabby slimes, so I'm just gonna. Bye, guys. Have fun in your new adventures. Okay. Anyway, that about covers the basics. Yeah, we beat the tutorial. Congratulations. There are some pink slimes chilling around here because it's the beginning of the game, but typically you don't want them to. So you can combine any two slimes together, and they'll make a new like combined fuse slime. But if you combine three together, then they'll become a tar slime, which is bad. They basically just exist to destroy. So you want to keep your slimes at least separated a little bit. Can't just let them run free. No, I know what I know what sandwich you're talking about. I meant like, what were you referencing? You said like our sandwich. What was like our sandwich? I think there might be an achievement, or maybe it's an in-game achievement for shooting a plort from like super far away into the stock market. Let me see if I can make it. Hold on. A little higher. Too high? Fuck. Let me try this again. I don't know if this is a real achievement. I can't remember. Slightly. Hey, I guess not. A Reuben sandwich? Maybe. So the slimes are going to be a mess. Oh, like our sandwich. That makes sense. Yes. Our sandwich was a huge mess. Well, I got all these fruits. So carrots and pogo fruits are both really basic. Pogo fruit is like the most basic fruit you can get. And the carrots like the most basic vegetable you can get. So like they're nobody's favorite, but they're good in a pinch when you need them. So it's not bad. Plus they grow everywhere in this early area. I think all the fruit and veg respawns once a day. Remember correctly? I think that's right. I might be making that up. They can be good for when you want to burst those like giant fat ones, because they're a little more. Oh yeah, we're starting to see them mix in the wild too. Let's get some more here. All right. This is like the easiest way to do it in the early game. It's just like you don't have to like really raise them on your own. You can just go find them out in the wild. Does no one hear Pikmin? Yeah, they make Pikmin-esque sounds. They make their little cries. They're like, meh. They're not quite Pikmin, but, you know, they're Pikmin-adjacent. And then if the game feels like there's not enough slimes, they'll just spawn more. So you don't have to worry about, like, overfishing, effectively. They'll always spawn more. You do have to be careful when there's more than, like, a couple different versions in an area, because they will start to make tar eventually. What is this, slimes on Wall Street? Yes. The stock market is very important in the world of slimes. Alright. Oh yeah, I can sprint, right? You have a little sprint meter. Oh, my my webcam is covering it. Let me just move this webcam. Bum, 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 bum. Put it over in this corner. Boop. That doesn't really cover as much. That's fine. How many people in the chat have messed around with Slime Rancher before? And how many people are seeing it for the first time right now? And how many people have heard of it but just never really messed with it? I don't really have their favorite fruits yet, or foods yet, so I'm just gonna just chucking carrots in there. Get that. Get that. Come on. So close. There we go. First time I've heard and see it. I've beaten two, beaten one, haven't played two. I also haven't played 2, but I'm doing that on purpose. Because I know 2 is not... It's still in early access, so it's not a finished game. And even though there's, you know... I'm sure I'd get a really fun experience if I played 2 right now. I'm just like... You know. Just trying to wait until it's, like, complete. Alright, let's add a roof so now they can't escape. And then... We want the plort collector next, and the auto feeder would be good too. Alright, we're good for now. So, the type of slimes we found so far are, there's the generic pink one, there's the rock one, which likes veggies, tells you its favorite, it likes the heartbeat, get it, heartbeat? Man, my phone is blowing up right now, give me a sec, guys. Then there's the tabby slime, which likes the stony hen, it likes meat. Then the phosphor slime likes fruit, it likes the cuberry, which is like a cube. Oh boy, I got a really long message here, hold on, I might have to respond to this, guys, give me a sec. I'll pause on YouTube. How do I pause this? There we go. Alright, we're back. Here we are again. Cool. I thought it was out, that's fair then. Yeah, I mean it's kinda out, but kinda not really. You know, it's one of those. Oh, there's another note here. Hello, Beatrix. The name's Hobson Twilligers. Rancher Explorer, the former owner of this here ranch you now call your own. Please make your acquaintance. I was a rancher for more years than I can remember and felt there was one last adventure left to me, so I set off to find just that. Before I go, I'm taking one last tour around this here land I love, so keep your peepers peeled for notes like this if you want to hear what an old coot has to say every now and again. Be talking to you, H. Thanks, man. Oh my god, I hate when, like, I already have notifications. My phone won't show the newest one, it'll just show, like, them in order. Guys, there are side effects of streaming every all of your day for like a week straight. Eventually, it's difficult and real life starts to peek in. It's like, hey, you get hungry and stuff, and hey, your friends are like gonna contact you about stuff. I'm like, oh yeah, right. But I'm streaming, guys. Like, come on. Obviously, I'm busy, and then I tell my friends to fuck off. I don't want to talk to them. Like. How dare they? How dare they speak to me? You want to speak to me? You can do it in YouTube chat. Can you imagine if I was like that? I'd be insufferable. Anyone who speaks like that is insufferable. Boop. I still have this fruit too. Oh, that's right. There is another thing we can do with the fruit. Oh, this little guy found his way over here. So there's a hidden cave around here. I forget exactly where it is, but it's close. That we can go to. I'm gonna do my best there. I think it's over on this side. Yeah, that sounds right. I don't have enough fruit for it, though. So the cave has another one of those giant slimes, but it's one of the giant, like, firefly ones here. That we've already seen. Oh, well, they're eating all the food already. Maybe I won't do it right now. There's no food left! Okay, I'll just keep collecting. I don't really have a plan, which is why I'm a little bit like, well, what do I do next? I'm like, what do I do next? You're such a parasocial streamer. Oh, yeah, I'm definitely that. Ice, can you imagine if you ever, like, you know, what if you had, like, a private Discord call with me? You don't get to do that, though, because you're not famous enough. I really only talk to people who can give me clout. So, like, sorry. I'm just too busy now. I'm just too big. I just don't have time for the little people anymore. Oh, what's in here? Entire cave system was sealed off from a cave-in when I first discovered it. Maybe that's why the fellows up ahead are so grumpy. Haven't had a bite in a long time. In any case, don't let that long-awaited bite come from your own rump. Bring some food to calm down. Okay. Time to Sudoku. Oh, jeez. What's everyone playing today? Sound like Pokemon? Yeah. What's everyone playing today? What are you guys messing around with? Damien said he just picked back up Vampire Survivors. I think that's pretty cool. So occasionally you come across these like vaults. They're just like passages. You need those slime keys that we grabbed from the fat boy that we popped. So they just unlock more areas, like the Indigo Quarry. Gym a few hours of Battle Brothers earlier. I don't think I've seen that one. Monster Hunter World for most of the day. Now in DayZ. Is DayZ still popping off? I don't think I ever got into it. So I was happiest when I was by my lonesome. Places like this old quarry really suited me. Nice and quiet and mostly empty. So I figured that life in the far, far range would suit me just as well. And well, wouldn't you know it? Come all this way and the first person I see, well, she changed how I saw things, I guess. Quiet wasn't good anymore. I liked her laugh. That's right. It's an indie love story. Alright, we got a couple new slimes here. Most notably, the Explody Boys. Boom Slimes. Shit. I'm gonna get out of here. Ow. Dragon Quest Monster 3... Dragon Quest Monster 3 DP? Neglect. Them all, I'm up to 73%. Do you mean the Switch one? Or do you mean Dragon Quest Monster Joker 3? Hidden chest there. Oh, we got another big boy. This one unlocks a teleporter. And he needs vegetables. Vegetables! Which I don't have, so. Switch one. Nice. I had fun playing that yesterday. Also, it's called the Indigo Quarry, and like it's mostly purple. I feel like. But that's just my opinion. Oh, we get the radiation slimes. I forgot about these guys. The rad slimes. They have an AoE, or kind of aura around them, that if you stand in too long, you'll die, and I can't get away because the other slimes block me in. Okay. I think there's a trophy for standing in their zone for like a certain amount of time. I think, but you can only do it once you have a certain number of, or once you have enough health, I think. Alright. I think we have enough of them. He's just eating a carrot. He's just grabbing the carrot with him. Alright, over here, you can sometimes find puddle slimes. They only live in water. I don't think they're appearing right now. Used to come here when I needed a good soak. It's a great way to clear your head. Sometimes I catch a puddle slime blushing. I can never tell if it was because I was in my bathing suit or not. Yeah, they're real shy. Oh, it feels good to be back in this game. I'm trying to, like, skip ahead, effectively. Or anything's a little faster than you're supposed to do them, so. It feels like I'm moving fast. It's because I am. Alright, this is a little hidden cavern. Where you can find some crystal slimes. These dudes are a bit rare. Their stuff sells for a lot of money. So I'm gonna try and grab up a couple of them. Forget what they eat though. They also like to just make spikes everywhere, which is rude. I once came here to collect crystals for a little project of mine. I was trapped here for nearly 2 days when those curious crystal slimes came rolling my way and started firing off those dangerous shards. Thought I was going to kick the bucket. Crystals were for a wind chime. I bet Thora still has it hanging from her porch. Worth it. Whew. Alright, any more popping out? I got you. And we got you. Perfect. Alright, I think we can make our way back now. If you do die, which you can, if you die, you'll end up having to restart the level. Or not restart the level, I'm sorry. You'll restart back in your farm, and it'll automatically progress to the next day. And you'll lose everything you had on you. So, it's worth it to be a little bit careful. Lave pair of social streamer combo, but how much to buy into the community multiplayer nights? What do you mean? Lilypad! She's the puddle slimes. Okay. Oh, that's kind of rare. Hold on. Get rid of all this fruit. Oh, but I should probably throw it at someone. Oh, but it's rare! I don't have that yet, and it's good. Alright, fuck it. Get out of here. I'm doing everything out of order here. I wish I had more inventory. That's Oka Oka. I think that's the favorite food of, it's favorite food of the rad slimes, I want to say. I don't remember, though. I remember bits and pieces of this game. Expand on what you're saying, Damien. I'm not sure what you're asking. Maybe you should get one more rad slime, just in case. Nah, we'll be good. Ba-bam, ba-bam. So I think slimes, if they're not in your pen, will eventually despawn. So that's kind of why you got to bring them back instead of just like open ranching. How much do I need to donate to be special? Well, currently the record for highest donation is from Under, who donated $1,069. But I think that's a tough record to beat. Just a dumb joke going off your parasocial persona. Oh, right. Yeah, that was on he did that on Monday. That's why this timer is so, he did that on Wednesday, which is why this timer is so high. A good start would be to become a YouTube member. That only costs $2. That's where everyone else in the chat has all these cool icons next to their names. Because that way they can also see the early videos and stuff like that. It's a good time. I recommend it for people who are like, hey, this Nick guy, he's pretty cool. You also get, oh, that's true. You also get all those emotes, which is almost a better prize. Yep, sure. It's why we got to save up for the next time he does this. Yeah. No, I'm sure next year I'll do it exactly the same way with no restrictions. I'm sure. I think next year may be a little different. Call me crazy. I just have a feeling. Oh, I don't want that. I didn't know you could go under there. No! Okay, we're good. Alright, sorry. I didn't mean to put you over there. I might want to buy some storage. I don't remember how much storage costs. 450. Ugh. Everything costs money. It's like the real world. I gotta start collecting some of these, which means I gotta figure out what to do with you guys. Say, go over there. Don't cause any trouble. Nope. Fuck. I said don't cause any trouble, and you immediately went to the nearest pen. What are you guys doing? Causing mischief? We doing mischief right now? Yeah, we'll forget by the time, yeah. You can comment early on member videos, make fun of Nick, that's true. Ice likes to pretend that he's aloof and that he doesn't like the channel. Oh, hey! Welcome to the party, Jake. I was gonna say, Ice likes to pretend that he's like, you know, it's like, oh, whatever, Nick. And then he'll also be the first person to watch every new video. And he'll comment on it. Ow. So he's like, oh, wow, whatever, Nick. And then immediately went, I'll post a video at 2 a.m. and he'll be the first watcher. And I'm like, all right, guys, enough of the Sundare act. Oh, just enough. Perfect. All right. I don't know what I want to put in here yet. I think I need to build it out a little bit more. I also don't know what to do with these boom slabs. Oh, woo. I was always here, bro. Hell yeah. So the Burnout video was like, damn, love Burnout. Yeah, there's another kind of PS2 throwback out there right now. It's members only still, but it's the... actually, is it scheduled for next week? I don't remember if I put it on the schedule. I think I did. The Mercenaries video is going to come out soon. That'll be a good time. It was fun to go back to Mercenaries. I feel like I'd enjoy it a lot more than I did when I was a kid, because I feel like I understand the mechanics better. Ice, I don't even like your content, Baka. Scheduled for Thursday, I think? That sounds right. I'm a little stuck here. As long as these are stuck in my inventory, I can't really do anything. But I need more money to buy them better space. Perplexing. I think I kind of did this a little backwards, but I was just so excited. Typically, it's better to like focus on one pen and make sure that one's like all squared away and then move on. Scheduled for Wednesday. Played Mercenaries in the ground, just dropped aerial bombs, always gratifying. I haven't gotten to any of the bomb stuff. I mean, I think the good thing about Mercenaries is that it does kind of live on a little bit with the Just Cause series. I think Just Cause is the closest we'll ever get to another Mercenaries game, especially since pandemic shutdown. Is it midnight? Merry Christmas, friendos. Hey, Declan. Merry Christmas to you as well. Bam, 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 bam. But yeah, so it's a different day. You can see that some of the prices are changing. Because I sold some of these. They're like, the prices are going down on them. It's kind of the game's way of saying, you can't just keep making money off the same slimes. You have to go hunt for more. And they're kind of right. Let's see. I only have 100. Fuck. Alright, let's do, you guys figure this out amongst yourselves. I believe in you. Although, I don't think they have any... I don't know what kind they are. Let's see. Rad slimes are vegetarians, and crystal slimes are also vegetarians. They like the odd onion, and they like the Oka Oka. Okay. Well, I could feed it the Oka Oka, but... I don't think that's a good idea, because I want to grow more, so I need to grow it first. Should use the missions, the animations. Let's go, only 8 more days of streaming, I know. I need to make more money. I should probably feed my slimes. I gotta find a heartbeat for these slimes. Oh, I can make money this way, I forgot about that. Help me out here, I'll make sure you get what you're owed. Alright, she wants 8 fruit and 9 chickens, and I've got 21 hours to do it. But she'll give me all these instead. The money is really what's worth it there. The odd onion's pretty good, too. I think I got some emails, too. Ooh, 4 emails. Welcome to the range from Thor West. Hi there, Beatrix. Name's Thor West. I'll keep my introduction short on account that we all got work to do. I'm a longtime rancher here in the far, far range and head of the welcome wagon for the local range exchange. Range Exchange is a network of ranchers just like yourself who are looking to trade whatever they got for whatever they need. Slime, sports, food, whatever. All you need to do is check out the Range Exchange machine daily and be sure to get your trade completed within 24 hours. As more ranchers get added to your network, you should receive a hearty hello from them, so check out, check your inbox. Well, left John, we both got slimes to wrangle. Adios, Beatrix. Adios, Beatrix, Dora. Rise and shine. Hey, B, what's it like to sleep for a whole year? Did you dream? I can't imagine what that's like. 7Z puts you in a pod and then lights out for all the time. Wow. What's the far, far range like? Have you started exploring? Is the air as clean as they say? I bet it's really beautiful. Probably asking too many questions. I bet you have a lot of work to do on that ranch. I still can't believe it's yours now. Guess I better leave you to it and just keep it short. Good luck, B. If anyone can make it out there, it's you. Aw. Secret Styles missing. Miss LeBeau, what if we told you that the Z Corporation has developed technology called Secret Styles that allows slimes to express themselves and show off their inner beauty as they saw it? If you answer that question, please know that we cannot hear you as you are reading star mail on a visual display unit. However, we proceed as if you are excited. So happy you're excited. Unfortunately, the cargo ship containing the secret styles exploded for completely unknown reasons and left them all over the far, far range. Please stay excited. 7Z Corporation's power to announce the secret styles for slimes are now available in unknown whereabouts throughout the far, far range. Please find them and test them. 7Z Corporation turning decisions to store boom plorts next to fire plorts and cargo holds into a glorious treasure hunt for Rangers. One cover up at a time. Is it a cover up if you tell me about it? And then just welcome me to the thing here. They're like the automated corporation that like does this. They're kind of evil, but like they stay out of my way, so it's fine. I'm seriously wondering if maybe you should pursue a career in animal husbandry with all the breeding you do in games. I know, right? All right, chat. I'm going to pause the YouTube recording. Well, 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 YouTube chat. What were you up to while I was gone? I see some clear rioting. All right. Let's get back to it. What was I doing? Oh, I need to earn money somehow still. Right, let's do this. I need 8 pogo fruits and 9 chickens. It's the 9 chickens that can be really difficult to get. Those chickens are not everywhere. Oh, the audio is still cranked up. Hold on. Let's put that back down. There you go. Tried to put it out. I need a water bucket emoji. Try to stop them, boss. They beat me and made me join, I swear. The evidence would say otherwise, but luckily evidence can't speak. Someone was asking, what game do you think I'm going to play next? I don't know. I haven't really planned that far. All I know is I'm tired. All I know is I'm a sleepy boy. I have not thought very far ahead, so we'll see. I don't know. It's so crazy. I've just been so many of these streams back to back. And I just like, man, like, I don't think I'd streamed longer than like 4 hours for like half a year. And like, I've done so many back to back. So currently I'm just like, just trying to, I don't know. We'll figure things out. Oh fuck. They're eating all the chickens. I can't store the carrots and the chickens. Okay. That's 3. I need 9. 9 is a lot of chickens. I have to like scour all the areas to find this. Alright, none over there. We didn't set the fire, but we also didn't stop the fire. Fair. How about Monster Train? I like to eat chicken. Am I a slime? Yes. I was thinking Banjo-Kazooie. I haven't played a good platformer in a while, I don't feel like. So I was thinking about giving it another go. Not to say that it's not worthy of, or that there's a reason I didn't have a go with it the first time. I just mean that I haven't played it in a while. I need you guys to grow up. Feels weird to stand over a baby chicken and just be like, I need you to grow bigger. We got him. I saved him. Grow! Grow! I don't know how long it takes the chickens to grow. BK is pretty fun, always a good time. OG BK or Nuts and Bolts? Probably OG. I tried doing a video of it on the Switch collection, and the Switch and 64 collection, I want to say last year. And didn't do very well. Didn't get a lot of views, so maybe I'll try it again and see what happens. Maybe it's a stream game. Who knows? I'm going to go try and check the cave. I just need 4 more. Nuts and Bolts is also solid. Just shouldn't have been a BK game. Yeah, I agree. I think Nuts and Bolts is a pretty clever game. With like the vehicle building and stuff like that. I also just like 100% still do not buy that it was always going to be a Banjo-Kazooie game. I think that's absolutely they're fucking full of it. Like there's no way. The story goes that Banjo-3E was becoming so big that they couldn't possibly get around the maps without vehicles. And then once they made vehicles, they were like, what if we made like a game out of it? And then And then that led to, what if we... Oh my god, it's the rest of the chickens. Yo, let's go. We're gaming. We're gaming. We're big time gaming over here. So then it went... Oh, there's a tar slime, by the way. The music changes and everything. They're very bad. But yeah, the legend goes that they were like, oh, it got so big, and then it's like, make vehicles, and then we made a game out of making the vehicles, and then it just became the whole game. I don't believe them. I think they're full of shit. I think what happened was they had this game that had like vehicle building and parts and stuff, and they probably still had some like animals in it, I think. And then someone was like, what if you made it a Banjo-Kazooie game? And I think they like slapped a Banjo-Kazooie skin over it. That, you know, I could be wrong. I could be wrong. Maybe they truly, truly did just want it to be that game from the start. I just don't believe them. That's what I mean. Because I think it came from like actual like Rare devs saying that like, no, we always wanted it to be this way. I'm like, I don't fucking believe you. I think you're full of shit. Shouldn't have thrown all those carrots out. I can't feed my other slimes. I'll find another source of carrots. We'll see. Again, I mean, Nuts and Bolts is still a really good game. It's just not Banjo 3. That's the big problem. Okay, so when you have one of these, just toss this shit in here. Woo! Boop. Shit, hold on. So these are odd onions. I believe odd onions grow with another food. They don't really grow on their own. So trying to plant one would be kind of not really what you want to do. But I do think it's one of these two's favorite foods. I don't remember which one it is though. It is the crystal slime's favorite food. So I'm gonna shoot him at the crystal slimes. Boop. Then they'll drop plorts, and then the rad guys will eat the plorts and turn into a big happy family. Okay. Can't really do anything with fruit because none of them eat fruit, so. Whoa, missed a couple things here. Star Fox Adventure way. Oh, can someone tell me about Star Fox Adventure? I don't really know how, is that, was that, was that a game where they were like trying to make a different franchise and or a different game, and then they like slapped Star Fox on it? It has like nothing to do with, or it has very little ship combat, doesn't it? Which is Star Fox's whole fucking thing. Whoa! How did you get out here, big boy? What are you? Wait, are you a? Are you Crystal Rock? What the fuck are you? Oh yeah, you're Rock Crystal. How the fuck did you guys mix? Oh, they must have somehow found their way to one of the plorts. Yeah, you're dangerous. I gotta get you out of here. Sorry. Goodbye. Oh, and you're here too. Oh, because you guys don't have a roof. That's right. Fuck, I need to make this money fast. Boop. Oh, hey, I got booped by a cat slime. Oh, I'm gonna die. Dangerous out on this them there ranches. Boop. It was a dinosaur game that indeed slapped Star Fox on it. I think also made by Rare. Yeah, so especially if it's Rare again, like, kind of sounds like they have a track record. I don't know. That might just be me. All right, I can make some much needed improvements now. So for you guys. Actually, let's not even focus on you yet. First of all, I gotta get this oak out of my hand. Out of my hand. Garden. Put the oka in there, and now it'll grow. Great. And then for you guys, how about a roof? And then, okay. All right. And then I guess I should start giving you guys basic amenities. So I'll give you a plort car. We'll go with the plort collector. I feel like that's the one that's annoying me the most right now. All right. Rare was the dev? Yeah, that sounds right. Ukulele wasn't. Also wasn't Banjo 3, unfortunately. Hot take, Nuts and Bolts the best BK game? That is a hot take. I don't agree with you, but I see. I can understand why you might say it. But Ukulele Impossible Lair is a really good Donkey Kong Country game. That's what I've heard. Ukulele is a really good, like, 2D game. Ukulele Impossible Lair is a really good 2D game. Didn't Enter the Gungeon do the same thing? Enter the Gungeon has their like whole normal mode. Oh shit, there's a lucky cat. I don't remember what to do with these. I think you have to like throw food at them or something. Yeah, it's gone. They only appear for a second. There's two kinds of like random appearing slimes like that. There's lucky slime or lucky cat, and then there's the gold slime. The gold slime, you need to throw something at them. Yeah, I don't know. Rare is an interesting journey. So we'll just, I mean, just to simplify that. They've kind of been all over the place. I still think they're really good devs, but they've had a strange journey. I do kind of think it sucks that they're basically just like gonna make Sea of Thieves forever, it seems like. I kind of wish they would do more, but what are you gonna do? I mean, they used to be really edgy. Like, Conker's Bad Fur Day is such an edgy game. And it'd be funny if they just, like, stayed that way their whole life. Like, just stayed, like a Duke Nukem-style kind of edge. Alright, this is another little hidden guy. He eats fruit. His favorite fruit is the, Q-berries. So if you feed the giant slime, the Largo slimes, if you feed their favorite food to them, it'll count as two instead of one. So if they need, like, 30 total food and you feed them their favorite, then you can feed them 15 of their favorite instead. Sometimes there are feral slimes like this. You kind of just go past them. You can make them unferal by feeding them, but because they constantly respawn, it's just not worth it. Like, they're going to attack you no matter what, so. You know what? I might, while I'm here, I might grab you guys. I don't really raise chickens because, like I said, I try to, like, breed out the carnivore nature of them. Not because I have anything against being a carnivore, but because it is so much easier to raise them on veggies. But I'll grab them, like, if I see them. At least Rare isn't stuck in the Kinect jail anymore. Oh, yeah. Didn't they make a bunch of Kinect games? Did they make the Han Solo or the Star Wars dancing one with, like, he's on Solo, he's on Solo? Like, that weird one. Oh, tar slime nearby. Oh, there they are. Also, you guys remember the R2-D2 360? The one that, like, when you hit the eject tray, it made, like, R2-D2 beeps? That's pretty cool. We should bring back shit like that. Just weird shit. Bring weird shit back to gaming. The people demand it. Oh, shit. Hold on. I need vegetables. Vegetables! Chainsaw controllers? I've talked about this, I think, before. I'm very upset about that chainsaw controller. I worked at GameStop when that chainsaw controller was sold, back when I was in high school. And, I mean, the amount of times I just saw that controller, and the amount of times I saw it on sale for, like, $20, and now it goes for, like, $800, I'm like, fuck. But then I think about it again, and I'm like, would I have held onto that controller for like 15 years? I'm like, no, I wouldn't have. It's fine. I definitely wouldn't have. Hungry boys. Hungry boys. Plort Peddler. That's me. I have the R2-D2 360 and a C-3PO controller. Did it now. That's pretty cool. Damien, I want to ask you another question. How do you feel about people who type out how, like, the phonetic spelling of 3PO and R2-D2? Where they'll use, like, they won't, like, use the acronym. They'll, like, type it out as in, like T-H-R-E-E-P-I-O. Instead of C-3PO. 3PO, yeah. Yeah, like 3PO. I think it annoys me a little bit. It shouldn't, but it does. Alright, so getting the auto feeder is pretty cool because it just means you can just do this shit. I don't have to go inside them to like, or inside their pen to go fish it out. R2, D2, oh, that's the one that really bothers me, the R2 one. Nice. I'm cool with it, fair. I don't know, I don't really like it. Got a little tiny pen here, I gotta feed you guys more. Oh, this is done, sweet. Nice, I have my own Yakuza. Yeah. Yakuza. That's my favorite character from Yakuza 0 is Koozie. Eat up, lads. You guys can have some too. I know you guys like vegetables. Vegetables! I don't want to die harvesting these. If possible. I'd like to live. I do think it's funny that this, like, chill, like, ranching game with, like, cute, cuddly slimes, you can just die while, like, grabbing their stuff. Up all night. Oh, yeah, I guess you can go back and rest in your bed, but there's no reason to. Koozie is dope, and his actor is also dope. Fantastic casting in that game. Yeah, I mean, they got all the actors who've been playing, Up All Night. They got all the actors who've been playing Yakuza characters in one way or another for years. And they were like, what if we got them to do it? And then apparently they love working with RGG, which is awesome. That makes me way happier. It's just knowing that they worked on the Yakuza games, and then they're like, and yeah, it was awesome. And I'm like, oh, that's what I want to hear. Yes. Fortunate. Earn over 5,000 new bucks. Okay. I'll buy you guys the auto feeder. I think that'll be good. Finally getting my stuff set up now that I've sold some shit. Give you higher walls. Give you a solar shield. Give you a plort collector. So I'm going to try and catch some of the nighttime slimes and mix them with these guys. Because that way they won't want to eat meat. They won't want to eat meat. I can feed them fruit. And they all seem super stoked on all the promo material. That's what it seems like. I think what's funnier is that it seems like if Yakuza went from like using like Jav idols as like kind of like an in-joke, being like the ones who are like hostess and stuff were like, you know, porn stars. And now it seems like people are like lining up to be the like hostesses in those games. They're like, oh, I can't wait, because they're like either fans of the game or like because it's popular. And I'm like, that shit's so cool. I love that it went from like this kind of like joke to being like almost like prestigious, where it's like, oh man, I really want to work for that. I think that's super cool. Just a cool series in general. Sure, we're having the pro wrestler has to be taken. Oh, that's true. I forgot about that too. They got pro wrestlers as well. Man. I guess we kind of do that with games here, but the problem is that when we do it with games, it's for like Call of Duty. I'd be like, we put Machete in Call of Duty. I'm like, oh, cool. I guess. Actually, I think Machete has been in a couple different... Danny Trejo, I think he's been in a couple different games. And we have him like kind of spread out sometimes too. I know Raul Coley likes to be in video games. So I guess it's different. One girl was a hostess. Many were recruitable characters in 2 Kiwami and 6 Battle Thing. Yes, that's right. Def Jam in 2 games? Oh, I guess that's true. I heard one of them is good. I forget. I think the first Def Jam is supposed to be really good, and the second Def Jam, I think Icon, is supposed to be pretty bad. I don't know the difference. I don't know why they'd be bad or good. You can beat the shit out of Snoop. It was really funny when for like 2 days, Snoop was like, I'm quitting. And then he's just like, just kidding. That's technically the third. It's not a, that's not one of the series that I have encyclopedic knowledge on. So I will refer. I think Earl just loves being in anything cool. I think that's true. I'm so glad he did those videos with Funhouse, because I would not have understood that he's like pretty fucking cool off screen. Like, I'd seen iZombie. I was like, yeah, he's funny. He's a good character, but I didn't know he was like pretty fucking funny. He's like a good, and he's like a gamer. That dude fucking paints Warhammer figurines. That dude's up there. Vendetta, Fight for New York, the best. And then I think it's either Fight for New York or Vendetta that's supposed to be the was the one I heard was good. Some of my slimes are getting a little antsy because I haven't fed them. I'm like, I can't. I need food to grow before I can feed you. I gotta really double down on the crystal slimes today, though, because they're still worth a ton of money. I can definitely get another harvest from them. Maybe Henry Cavill will cast him in the Warhammer series. I think he said that. I think he, like, reached out. I also think Raul cleaned up his like social media stuff. Like, he deleted his Twitter, he did all this stuff, and he like got removed from a couple different videos and stuff. I think he's probably in the talks for some like higher level projects. And I don't usually care about actors when they get cast in different stuff. I'm like, yeah, whatever. But like, for some reason, when I hear that like Raul might be like getting some like cooler and like better castings, even like a Star Wars thing, I'm like, you know what? Good for him, man. Hell yeah. I don't know. It's cool to see people like kind of grow when you're like actually paying attention to him and not just like, oh yeah, this guy, I can't believe he's in this. Cavill? I said Cavill. What do you mean? Also, once again, I'm the one with the microphone. However I pronounce it is correct, because there's no other pronunciations. I own a microphone, and yet I don't hear it. That's crazy. And truly, if you don't hear a microphone, does it really exist? Not to get too existential here. I'm gonna try and go burst that that slime underground, because I have a bunch of fruit, but I don't know if it'll be enough. You guys like the exaggerated Hulk Hogan hand potion? I need you to grow faster. I am a real American, fight for the rights of every man. I say that as my pants are falling down. Oh yeah, we busting slimes, let's go. This might not be enough, though. I think this one only takes 30, but it might be 50. I think it is 50. Fuck. I don't have any more fruit. Oh, I think I mentioned recently the difference between, like, American Fanta, like the soda, and, like, UK Fanta. Or Fanta. I remember, like, I was talking about that, how it's like a different color completely. Like, it's like night and day. I did forget about it, and I saw it on Twitter again recently. I'm sorry, X. That there is another. There is another, like, American versus the rest of the world food that's just, like, weird, and it's Fruit Loops. I forgot Fruit Loops are, like, all this, like, super, like, bright and vibrant colors in the U.S., and then outside of the U.S., they're just, like, muted. Because they have to use real ingredients. Just like, I'm just like, fuck, man. They let us eat everything. Like, I think Mexico in particular, I was reading, Mexico doesn't even let you have cereal mascots anymore. They just, they have to just be like plain and just have like a logo on them. I'm like, yeah, I guess so. It kind of shouldn't, you shouldn't really be allowed to market to kids, I kind of feel like, but that's just me. That's my hot take. you shouldn't really be able to allow, you shouldn't be allowed to market to kids because they don't have money. Like, it's weird. And then also, secondary but attached hot take. Shouldn't be legal to market medicine. I don't think it should be legal to have commercials for medicine and then just be like, oh, ask your doctor about it. Why the fuck? Can you imagine being a doctor and hearing one of your fucking patients be like, hey, I saw this commercial for this medicine. Can you prescribe it to me? No. What? No. What? How the fuck did that happen? Like, how did that happen as a society? Yeah, and then it's also like listing like 7 million effects. Yeah, that's the other part of it. I believe in you guys. Tasty. Oh, I think that's for shooting a hen right into a slime's mouth. Yep. I guess I could upgrade those. Or I could upgrade my food. Only ads I watch are SkyCorp ads. I don't know what that is. He's made that up. I refuse advertising my life. I mean, advertising works sometimes. I think my new pet peeve is like Facebook and Twitter ads and like Reddit ads that like look like Facebook, Twitter, and Reddit posts. Where they'll be like, today I learned that Apple Jacks are the cereal that has real cinnamon in it. I'm like, shut up. Shut the fuck up. Just get away from me. Don't use any of them for stuff like that. It's just, you know, you'll just see it when you're scrolling. It'll just be doom scrolling before bed, and it'll just be like, I'll like think it's an ad, or I'll think it's like an actual post, and it'll be like, oh man, you know who does it the worst? Food prep services, like HelloFresh, Factor, all of them. They'll do I think Factor is the one that I see the most, where they'll do like, they'll make it look like it's a normal social media post, and it'll be like, and then I tried Factor, and food prep became easy. I'm like, ah, shut up, ugh. Get away from me. That not everyone should have a voice. I think everyone should have a voice. I just think that, like, you know, sometimes we should bring back bullying. And if someone has a voice and they're saying something stupid, bully them. It'll work. I'll be sponsored by them in a month. I bet if I reached out to HelloFresh, I could get a sponsorship. I don't want to do HelloFresh and I don't want to do Raid. Specifically because there's like three different ways you get paid, I think. It's like, hey, we'll pay you just like as a baseline just for doing this, and then you have to do like a sponsored thing for like 2 hours. And then also we'll pay you more if like 25 people sign up for the service. And then I think Raid in particular, Raid will be like, hey, if you catch a few whales, like if you get 5 players who like are super max leveled within like a month, then we'll pay you even more. And I'm like, okay, well, I don't want to do that because I don't want to take a sponsorship that like potentially hawks a product to my subs that like I don't like. I think that would be a very bad idea. Just from like a personal, like, how do I sleep at night kind of point of view, I don't think I could do it. I would do one of those meal kit ones. I won't do HelloFresh. I signed up for HelloFresh and I did it for like maybe like 2 months. And it was just too much. It was too much cooking. That's really what it came down to. Because like every single meal from HelloFresh was just like perfectly portioned to be like one or two meals. And I'm like, I don't want to cook 5 times a fucking week. I want to cook 2 or 3 times a week and then have leftovers. Like, and I'm just like, no. but HelloFresh in particular, ever since I stopped using them, I get so much fucking junk mail from them. Like, I get a new like thing in the mail from HelloFresh like once a week. Maybe like once every 2 weeks. And I'm like, stop it. Just stop sending this. I'm not doing you again. Like, I'm just like, I mean, HelloFresh was good. I learned some new recipes that like I do use now. The big thing is just like, I can't do this forever. If it was like, hey, we'll send you like 4 meals every like 2 weeks, I'd be like, that's fine. But it's like, hey, here's 3 meals a week minimum. I'm like, oh, that's too much. I don't want to cook that much. Because, like, you know, I'd finish work, and then I'd spend, like, fucking just, like, 2 hours cooking. Because I've got this 8-step fucking recipe I've got to do with all these ingredients. I'm like, ah. I just didn't want to do it. Factor, on the other hand, seems pretty good. Because it's just, like, it's microwavable meals. So, like, you know. I haven't tried them, but it seems like that would be the easiest one. Just fucking microwave it. Who gives a shit? I mean, I will say, if you want to support, like, smaller streamers and YouTubers and stuff like that, and you can, you should engage with, like, the advertising stuff. Because, like, you know, it helps out the YouTuber. I mean, be a smart consumer. Don't just do whatever. But, like, if you can help out, or if you're like, oh, I've been meaning to try that, and, you know, I guess since this streamer has a code, maybe I'll give it a shot. I think that's fine. I think that's a good compromise. That's why you got my 2 hours. There you go, see? I mean, I also think that, not to toot my own horn. I think for $2, I've got a pretty good, deal going on here. Early videos and, emotes for $2, and you get to support us. I think that's fine. I put the lowest possible cost. You can do 2, 5, or 10, and they all give you the same thing. It's just if you're just like, oh, I think you're worth $5, then you can do that. I think quick new buck is for getting $5,000 in one day, which I think I just did. The price of crystal plorts is gonna tank because I just sold so many of them. It's gonna absolutely just like, yeah, 5,000 a day. Well, I'm glad that my like insane like me trying to like game the system kind of paid off a little bit, and I was able to make like money way faster than I'm supposed to. Maybe you feel better. Oh, I fucking, it's a goddamn berry. What are you doing? All right, we gotta start growing some fruit. Boop. Let's try and improve it, I guess, too. Make it faster. Nutrient soil, sprinkler, yep. And then nutrient soil, sprinkler, yep. So I have fruit and I have veg. I don't have a source for meat, but I try not to need one. Victor Humphreys, if possible, please acquire the following for future study. My thanks. He needs 4 red, 6 rock, and 6 normal, and he gives 250 and then a bunch of veggies. The heartbeats would be nice. Heartbeats are a favorite food of our friends over there, but I don't feel like it. Is really what it comes down to. Especially right now, for just $2, you get like 70 worth of content. Oh my god, there's a lot of hours of content behind the members block right now. Here's what I'm looking for. I'm gonna grab a couple of these guys. And mix them with the boom slimes. I don't mean to pay for content I know I'm going to engage with and prefer to pay direct than hope ad money makes to a creator. Yeah, that's exactly what I mean. I'm the same way. I subscribe to a couple different ones. I do a couple different artist Patreons just to throw them like a buck or two. I'm like, yeah, I want to see what you do. I want to see how your career progresses. And I've dropped people too. Sometimes I'll do like a YouTube membership or I'll do like a Patreon, and I'm like, eh, I kind of got what I needed out of this. I kind of see what you're doing. You're maybe not what I was hoping for. And then sometimes I'll check back in. And I'll just be like, you know, maybe it's a different kind of setup now. I go back and forth. I mean, ultimately, I think that's what it's about, right? It's like, if you enjoy something, you know, throw some money at it so you can enjoy more of it. And it's not living up to your standards, then, you know, you're not locked into anything. I think the best thing to do, though, and I don't really ask people for this. I wish YouTube had kind of like an exit survey or something. Because if people stop becoming a member, I do kind of wish I knew why. Because, like, if they stop becoming a member, like, sometimes it's stuff that I can fix. Like, if it's like, oh, they didn't Nick didn't have enough videos available for members. I'm like, all right, well, that's fair. I'll try and have more. There's not really much else I can do. Or if it's like, or if it's like, oh, I just couldn't afford it anymore. I'm like, yeah, that's fine. Can't really bug that. So, we'll see. I don't like subscription. I do an end-of-the-month check on all my money. It's like 50 cents, I'm sure. How much do I get from YouTube again? I think YouTube I get like 2/3 on membership. I used to get 2/3 on super chats, but now I definitely only get half from the super chats, which is why I try not to do those. And I try to do like the Streamlabs donations. It's fine because like YouTube makes it a little easier for taxes, but like that's too big of a cut. No, the membership is good. I like the membership as it is because it's a good metric. This sounds weird, but it's like having more channel members in your channel also makes YouTube like more likely to put me in the algorithm because they're like, oh, well, this guy, you know, people are kind of engaging with this. So we should do more with it. So I don't mind that. Yeah, the back end does help for YouTube too. It's pretty much that. And also at the end of the day, I'm using YouTube service. So like they can take as much as they want. Realistically, what am I going to do? Go on somewhere else? No. So I don't mind it. So yeah, this is what I was talking about, the stock thing. So these were selling for 95 because I sold like 40 of them. The price got halved. So now they only sell for 51. So that's kind of how the stock market in this game works. The ideal way you should do it is kind of the way I did it, which is load up on as many as you can. And once you have as many like plorts of one type and you haven't sold it yet, just fucking unload them on the stock market. And then the price will tank, but you'll have made so much money that it'll be worth it. I'm gonna buy a silo for storage. I think that'll be good. Do you have the solar shields? No. Here's the auto feeder. I'll do the music box too, just in case. Alright, now I gotta find fruit to feed him. I mean, I guess I'm growing the fruit, right? So I just gotta wait. Alright, that seems like a good point to end on for part one of Slime Rancher, I guess. Part season three, whatever the fuck I'm going to call this. Like I said, I've played Slime Rancher before on the channel, but I thought I would do a new playthrough because I miss it. It's a good game. I really enjoy it. So that'll be the end of this recording. Thank you, guys. If you want to see more, as always, hit that like button, leave comments, let me know what you think. And yeah, well, I'll see you guys later. Bye-bye.